There's gotta be something there, right? You have done well, Inigo. You have passed the trial of strength. If it be strength you seek, then step forward. Inigo has returned to the entry of the Cave of Strength. Trial passed. Strength! A new path lies open before you. Alright. So... right, this is the stairs down. Let's see, hold on one second, guys. Okay, yeah, I had to consult my map. So we're here by the stairs. To the right of us, this was formerly a wall right here. So this goes up and around. And I'm like actually not gonna go that way just yet. Killer gnome? Is that a different gnome than before? Or does it just look different in this light? Wachunga! Nice. I'm gonna miss that when I return him to the... what do you call it? The town. So that goes up ahead, and that ends up going to... the Cave of Courage. There are stairs down to the Cave of Courage, and there's also some tunnels up there that, drain your magic when you stand on them. And there's a couple items up there. There's a smelling salts and a morning star, believe it or not. But I'm like not even gonna go that way yet. I'm gonna save that for when we actually start heading there. Because I mean, we don't have room to even carry anything else, so I want to sell the extra short sword. I actually wonder. I was looking at an equipment listing, and it was saying that Pyra could use a short sword. She can use it, okay. I wouldn't think that was possible. I guess I should have had her use that, I should have tried that before. Oh well. She has it now, so now she can, we can sell the bronze knife. That's pretty cool. We found one short sword. So since we're so near the exit, we might as well just leave manually. I think... yeah, we go down this way. Scavengers. Chunga! That's alright. I get to see her short sword in action, though. Nice! Maybe she can actually do some damage now. I mean, she's a magic user. You wouldn't think she could use a sword. Wachunga! Love it. Long hallway of doom. Ah. Sweet. Yeah, that makes a big difference. Oh, we have to use this just to get out as well? That's interesting. So it's another inventory slot that we can't use up. It's just so ridiculous. I think we go down here? Oh, so much trouble. You can one-shot all of them now. Oh no, not this way. You figured I'd know this way. Nice. 38 she gets to do, and 39. What awesome blows for all of us. I wonder if critical hits, the chances for them increase as we... That's back where we came from. So close, yet so far. No. Then it's gotta be this way. You know, it's funny, I don't come out this way. I've been using the angel feather. Yeah, it's right around the corner. One more ooze. I'll take care of that. Oof. Now, before we head back to town and we lose his abilities, I want to check the castle to see if they have anything new to say. They might have something to say about his presence in our party. Theo says, "You're about to face the trial of courage, aren't you? Well, listen. The Cave of Courage is designed to test a knight's bravery. It is also a place known to instill fear in magic users." Great. Being that two-thirds of our party is magic users. "You have passed the trial of strength." "Yes, I know that, Ace. But you have yet to face the three remaining trials." Oh my god. Tell me something I don't know? That's all he has to say. Alright. "Passing the trial of strength opens the way to the Cave of Courage." These guys are very obvious, except for... What's this guy's name? Theos. He actually gave us, you know, slightly informative and worrying news. "One of my men came crawling back like a whipped dog. Perhaps there's nobody in the realm capable of passing the trials." I just did pass one of them. "Fyron has sent men to face the trials before, but to no avail. I believe you to be our only hope. May success be yours." Why, thank you. "Inigo, you must earn the right to enter the labyrinth proper." Okay, I think that's what he said before. Okay, back to the town. Tempted to just not bring this guy back, but... That's a long way around. Well, if it isn't Inigo! Rumor has it that Vyron has sent some men out to face the trials. Nothing new to say. Way past opening the bronze door, but thank you. I wonder when this guy leaves our party. Maybe he doesn't? And he... Oh, there he is. Good morning! Inigo, I think it's time we parted our ways. In return for your help, I'd like to give you a piece of information. I've heard that the Orb of Truth is in the Cave of Courage. It's said that the orb reveals the true nature of things. To tell you the truth, I was after the orb and not the princess. But with these wounds, I'd be a fool to go after the orb. Well, I'd better go now. Thanks for your help, and I hope we meet again. Why, thank you. Let me just go check now that that happened. Looks like nothing new. Alright. Now we must have a lot of money. Woof! Nice. I wonder what if we should get new weapons or new armor? Well, let's sell this bronze knife then. Oh, I'm on Inigo. Yes, we have a deal. Is there anything else we want to be selling? Oh, isn't there a woven robe? Yeah. Cool. Woven is... You know what? Let me hold on to that. They do sell that, right? I'm just trying to remember. I just want to make sure it's not some special kind of robe that's better than what we have. Cotton? Yeah, woven. Okay. Alright, so I'll just sell it here. I don't think we have anything else to sell. Unless... We'll sell the Wisdom Seed. So they're wearing a hemp robe. Oh, fur robe? Oh, sorry, he's still wearing a fur robe. Thank you. I'm gonna buy the chainmail for Inigo. We'll also find out that Milo can also use it. We're so sure that you want it. Oh well. It's in the deals, right? No special deals to offer today. Okay, so he has deals in different sections. You have to manually go into each one. A breastplate for 1850. Kind of wondering. I'll get that next time. Nothing. I'm gonna give this D poison to Pyra. And then you the chainmail to Inigo. Now Inigo will equip the chainmail. ~55 to ~65 armor factor. Sweet. Awesome. Alright, so now we can go sell the fur rub and then see what else we want to do from there. I'm more inclined to help the other two, because they're not as strong as in defense and offense as Inigo is. Pay a good amount of money for that. So what do we have now as far as money? So 2,000. So what are we wearing? The hemp robes? I wonder if she can use that. She's full though. It's a pain in the butt having to deal with this limited inventory. Now I'm wondering if Pyra can use it. Pyra can't use this. Okay. Milo's got chainmail. Now I know, why don't I just sell what he has on, right? But I like to look at how it increases. I'm funny like that. So from leather armor... Actually, I'm wondering if she could use a leather armor. Does she already have leather armor? From 48 to 54. She's a hemp robe. So he's wearing the chainmail now. Can she equip? No. Alright, so we might as well sell the leather armor. Hope this isn't too boring to watch, guys. I don't know. I like to watch people figure these things out, so I figured someone else might as well. Yes, we have a deal. Still 1403. So she can't wear leather armor and she can't wear chainmail. Bronze armor. I wonder if she can wear that breastplate. Have enough money for it. What does she have as far as... Okay, she has a cloth hood. Let's see if I can increase her hood. Helm type thing. Leather helm. You know, I would really give her a bronze helm. I doubt she can wear it though. But she can wear, she can use a sword. I can't use it, so you still want it. No. Can she wear the fur head? Okay, good. Okay, let's see what this does for her. She has a cloth hood. And she's gonna switch to fur. 53 to 61. That's pretty significant. Seems so, anyway. Now to sell the cloth hood. I know, I do things the long way. I like to see how the points go up, and you. I don't think there's a way to see that on the fly in the shop, so. Hence we do this. Selling the cloth hood, 90 gold pieces, yes. I mean, at some point, we're gonna have, like, not as many things to buy, I think. Unless he comes up with a crap load of stuff as we get higher. Anything else you want to sell? No. I think we're done. Here, 463 gold. So Inigo has a leather helm, leather shield, and short sword. And chainmail. Leather helm. Milo just has the cloth head. I wonder if he can wear a leather helm. Does Milo have room to... Yeah. Yeah, we could afford it for him. Else, do we? Can he wear a woven hood? I'm just assuming the more expensive item, the better. Okay, I'm guessing that is. For the 58. It's not that much, but... Okay. So we'll probably end up getting him the leather hood next time. So now we'll sell this hood. I just want to look at our stats again. Or rather, our items. Alright. So I wonder where we can put Milo's other hand. I wonder if he can use a shield. I think he can't. I know a pirate can't. At least not the starting ones. Also, healer. I keep looking at that and thinking it's a hat. Alright, hemp robe, fur hood, short sword, and a short sword. Chainmail and a woven hood. And a short sword. Leather shield. Leather helm. And smelling salts. So wait, is his woven hood... The woven hood is better than? I don't even know if I can afford it. $450. How much will they buy that for? They'll pay 225 gold. toilets, so we have three. Yeah, we don't have enough anyway. Kind of wondering if he can use it. But we'll have to wait on that. Bear with me, guys. I just want to check here again. Now that I dropped him off, just wondering if anything new might happen. I don't think there's anything new. Yeah, there's nobody. Totally nobody. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for our next episode when we head to the Cave of Courage. Until then, always seek adventure.